with almost 60% of members of the public seeking for health services in private clinics due to several setbacks affecting public health centers. The increment of the cost of treatment in private clinics will be a big blow to the general public. A week ago, clinic operators took to the street to protest the new trading license of over 400,000 shillings, which was imposed on them by Kampala Capital City Authority, on top of the already high taxes they were paying. To date, government has not responded to their plea. Led by former Bukoto South legislator Dr. Lunu Mebaiga, clinic operators insist it is wrong for KCCA to levy taxes on them because they are not traders.
A health facility is not a shop. A health facility does not sell bags, it doesn't sell cameras, it doesn't sell clothes, it doesn't sell shirts, it doesn't sell sugar, alcohol, and so on. We are not bars. We are not traders. But when KCCA operatives come and close down health facilities which are licensed to practice, they find the health workers treating people and they close them down. Only to come back in the evening, they ask for 30,000 to open you. What kind of work, what kind of businesses are they transacting?
When you force this trading license on medical practitioners, what is going to happen? It is that all the people who are down this way in the ground level, they are going to suffer because you signed on this law without people who are nearby you to advise you. They didn't advise you rightly. They told you, sign on the law. They were looking after getting money, but the repercussion is in fact they are going to affect the person who is down.
Their lawyer, Agrim Shagare, has however notified Chief Justice Batka Turebe about the delayed court case they already opened up against KCCA. He revealed that it is 2 months now since the case was filed, but has never been heard.
Even that the matter is not addressed appropriately, I will have no option to leave my clients to take action in their hands to demonstrate. We never know the president of Uganda who assented to this bill and it became operational as law might come up and address the concerns of these people.
If this fails, the medical practitioners have threatened to hike the cost of medical treatment or lay down tools effective 8th this month.
They close my clinic when I'm treating my patient and then they claim batutumyabu to me. That is fake. Acting foolish. How can you close me up? And my clients are there. Okay, let them send you people, mweba enforcers, let them send you to come and eat blood in my clinic because you have just been sent. Okay? It is a call to all patients. You are going to start paying consultation fees in my clinic because you've seen licenses have been put on me, my clinic is being closed and you're there seated thinking, ebisawo kababijeko musolo. Okay. But to Jacob Musolo, but remember when a boda knocks your child next to my clinic, you can never run to Chiludu. You just enter in family clinic. And I will have to charge you money, a lot of money, if you don't know.
This trading license on me, for example, we are paying something like 1.5. In addition to the other taxes we are paying, what does it imply? I have to torture you as the client or as the patient such that you can pay me the money that I can use to pay the government.
The previous response by Kampala Capital City Authority was that this trading license was introduced by Minister of Trade in the amended Trade License Act, thus making it mandatory for private clinic operators to pay. KCCA vowed to continue enforcing the tax levy.
As Ugandans celebrated the Labour's Day today, the clinic operators in Kampala saw no reason to celebrate. These claim that the high taxes imposed on them are more likely to kick them out of business. Juliet Namwaya, Aban TV.